In Yunnan, we stayed with some friends, and in their house, they had this really cute and unique little teacup. It was made by a pottery maker in a nearby village, not by a traditional potter's wheel, but it was squeezed out by hand, leaving a really rough and unique finish, which made me really curious about the guy and his technique.
So we are going to go visit him today, and hopefully I can get to film a little mini documentary about him. That's the dream, but we'll see.
Things didn't exactly go according to plan, but for now that's unimportant. Let's just focus on the beauty of our high lake that we walked along before we went to visit the pottery maker.
The windy place, which is very true, it's just constantly blowing, but it's hot, it's so hot.
The short documentary about this particular pottery maker was simply not meant to be. He's not too fond of cameras. A very warm, helpful and welcoming guy though, giving us a guided tour of his house and his workshop, answering all questions we had. This
photo is who took it?
It's
a teacher's teacher.
Oh. We made sure we got to meet a special someone.
<音><音>
对，就现在这种釉，他们都做不出来了。以前也是这里做的。这个颜色你知道是怎么做的？就已经失传了，不知道怎么做的。对，本地没有师傅知道是怎么做的，就是这种颜色。现在最常见的，他们烧的最常见的就是这种颜色。
嗯。
还有就是这个罐子这种颜色。就这一个。 这个呢？这个也是，这个也是比较常见。这个就是草木灰，就是一些草啊跟木头，把它烧成灰，然后用水淘洗一下做成的釉，它也是天然的釉。就是这个草，它是放水的，然后盖个盖子，它就可以隔绝空气，里面就可以放那些菜啊。啊，
所以是做酸菜。对。
So the guy here, he has been doing this for 4 years, but he's not from here, and he does not like being on camera, so he's not gonna appear in the video, but he knows some older people up in the mountains who does this as well, all by hand, doesn't use any electricity for anything, so we're gonna go and see if we can find them as well. But I will show you a little bit of what they're doing here. It's really, really beautiful.
This
is tao tu. Tao tu. It has
red, and it has black. And it has a
little red. This is what you
use to use? Yes. This is to
use the debris. To use the debris. Where did this tao tu come from? It's from the mountains. It's very rare. 哦，就带一些回来试试看，效果一不一样？
啊，这个确实粘一点，但是很细腻啊。嗯。 很丝滑，把那个淀粉拿上一点感觉，淀粉放在水里面就这种感觉。
我在鸡爪庵摆了一个小摊，就是上午的时候，所以我做陶的时间会少一点，一般都是多吉在做，多吉做的比较多，我一般是下午回来或者晚上才做。要是温度烧高了，这个陶它就受不了了，它就会塌掉。它在某个状态它是软的，它就会塌掉。
所以要几度最好？
最好像我们就烧到1310就不会再烧了，再烧高就受不了了陶。
哎呦我的天！
它里面有个糊，糊不能吃。它这个就是捏一下，它不会有那种涩的感觉。不然直接吃它会更涩。你可以尝一下，超级酸。
你这怎么样，老公？
好吃啊！
我嘴里干了，
酸但是 你肯定喜欢。
因为哎呀，确实有点涩。
嗯。妈妈，
来。
We're on our way to the master now, and they're up in the mountain, so hopefully they haven't left yet because it's kind of dinner time. But we're keeping our fingers crossed.
你干什么？
回去叫哦。
这不做陶已经做了几十年了。十几岁就开始做，
对啊，祖传的嘛，
祖传的，几代了？
十几代了吧，到我手里面。
哦，
十几代，
这得600多年历史，你说嘛？
师傅是不是姓杨？
对。
你是每天做？
对面中间
天天在做。
天天在做，一天能做多少个？
啊，一天做不了几个，一天就是三四十个吧。
三四十个。
比这个小的可还好一点。
这个不是很多吗？三四十个。
这个顶多就做40个。
挺多的呀。Really good news. We can come here and film a little documentary about this shifu later. And also, you can come here and study. And it's 120 renminbi per day. And you study for about 10 to 15 days. So that's like, it's just really cheap. You study all day for 120 renminbi. I think. think that's crazy. So Yonghong and I are both very interested in doing this, but I guess we should do the documentary first.
Er det fint, Lian?
Han shui, de kaller han Longyang. 然后一个洞一个洞的，然后把东西先放进去，那有一个小门，然后从那儿投柴，然后这样烧，是吧？对。对啊。一批啊。对。那烧。明天开始来这里当学徒，我给你一把。好乖呀。1120。
我说这些房子以前都是做陶的师傅住的，他们就在这上面做陶，后来就不赚钱，就没什么人做，都荒废了。Being
there was quite an emotional experience, knowing it must once have been a place where the wheels were constantly spinning and fires burning regularly in the many ovens. Ovens that now, along with the old workshops, had almost all caved in. Place that now lacked both water and workers, so essential to the craft.
So we will be back hopefully, but we're gonna head off soon and yeah, just gonna say goodbye and then we're off.
温度不同，它烧出来也不一样，颜色也不一样。对，颜色。这个模具就是这罐罐，开始我们上面它不是做完以后。 装完以后没有完全干的情况下，用一个模具，然后在这上面敲敲敲，就成了这个花纹，花纹不同的花纹。看一下地区花。I
haven't actually been craving travel or anything like that. I'm usually quite happy just staying at home, but going out, going to somewhere new and meeting new people and seeing new things and practices have been really good for me, I think. I'm very happy to have gone here to Yunnan, and it's just, I don't know, it gives me a lot of inspiration and new ideas. And new things, you know, I have a new dream now of learning to do some of this, this type of ceramics. So I'm hoping that we can do it.
This is a tree called Huanglian Tree. It's about 150 years old. 我可以叫她树爷爷，也可以叫她树太爷。我以为你在拍我。我以为她是婆婆呢。哦，那我可以叫她树奶奶。我下来了。下。这就上山了。
People are moving here from all over China and all over the world, and I really understand why.
In a few videos, I'll dive into what the coming plan to return to Yunnan really means. But before that, you'll get to follow along on one more handicraft adventure, also just outside of Dali.
Mm-hmm.